So we're here at Slam in Hamburg, and perused their very nice record collection, and we found some stuff that we like, some oldies but goodies mostly. Who's Quadrophenia here? Classic four disc epic record. That's a staple for anybody who's into, you know, rock music or concept records. It's very well thought out story in the vein of something like maybe The Wall, for example. Like,
but way before The Wall.
But before, way before it. So, yeah, this is a great one. If you know, not a lot of people that I talk to in the metal world or people that are our age or really give The Who enough of a time of day. These guys were shredders and pretty darn
smashing stuff on stage and being all sick.
Yeah.
Another oldie, Metal from Pink Floyd. I picked this one because I think that this record is a really great example of a band being right on the cusp of greatness, and it, you being able to actually hear it. You know, this song, this record has echoes on it, which is the entire second side of the record, and I think that up until that point in their career, you know, they had experimented with many different, you know, awesome sounds, but I think the direction that they were headed in after this record and hearing echoes was like, it was very clear that something had changed in the band and that they were heading in the new direction that would become, you know, Dark Side of the Moon. So, very important record, and one of my, you know, definitely my favorite pre-Dark Side of the Moon record from Pink Floyd.
Violator, a classic from Depeche Mode, the electronic music pioneers. This is one that you can put on whenever a girl makes you sad, or a boy, or whoever, somebody makes you real mad about being alive. You can listen to this one.
We listen to it a lot. When the band was first starting, we would do a lot of really long drives in our old van, and we listened to a ton of this album. And yeah, so whenever I hear this record, it kind of reminds me of like the earliest days of Rivers of Nile, and just driving around in our horrible blue van and playing shows to nobody.
There's pictures of me somewhere that my parents probably have of me when I was like 5 years old wearing a Depeche Mode shirt my dad gave me.
Oh, that's sick.
So yeah. That was like, you know.
Yeah.
That band's like kind of always been around.
And the last one is Gentle Giant, self-titled. I picked it because I think it's some of the coolest artwork that I can think of. Just weird, I guess. But also really great gateway into prog rock. I would say like this was like the record that my dad played for me when I was a kid, along with, you know, Dark Side of the Moon, that kind of like sold me on progressive rock. It's like normal enough that like a person who's only listened to like pop music could like get into a whole other genre through this record, I think. Plus, like I said, the artwork's amazing. Really sick production.
The artwork, yeah, it's just one in a long line of great records that just feature a big face on the cover.
Yeah, some other band had a face on their cover. I don't know.
A couple of
band that would be.
This is King Crimson.
Oh, right. But yeah, Gentle Giant.